What's up, y'all? It's Lip Service. Y'all ready to have some fun today? It's Angela Yee.
I'm Stephanie Santiago.
I'm Gigi McGuire.
I'm L'Oreal.
And we got Black Youngster here.
Well, I know what's going on. What's poppin'? We out too.
I wasn't here last time. I'm L'Oreal.
Yeah, I see you.
But we was they were in here twerking before you came up here.
You shake your booty.
You know, we love your new video.
I was trying to teach her how to do big booty work.
Exactly. Because I don't know how to do all that. Gigi know how to do
I'm going
to
come out with my booty workout DVD. Oh. So I'm going to teach it as possible, for sure.
No, for sure.
You got to turn up, though.
You know that's what I do.
You know, right. Gigi was like the queen of Magic City. She was the number one. She was the on the cover of the calendar.
We going to see.
So
we're going to hold you to that now. I got to see some of your movie first.
Go ahead, right. Gigi.
Let me see some of the moves.
Gigi, why don't
hold
we
down,
see
I'm
going
to
put
moves.
The song up. Whoa.
I'm not.
Oh, look at her right moves now. Right there. No champagne. Kid.
All right, yeah. I'll just pull up your Instagram page.
There you go.
And I'm going to show you some of her moves.
Please, and show me right now.
Oh, he's saying he don't believe your Instagram. He said your Instagram's a liar.
Because let's be clear, right? When you go to the strip club, don't you want girls that don't just walk around and do that? You want them to do shit like tricks mm-hmm. and, you know, all of that on stage.
I want them to dance, go on a pole. No, I don't go on a pole because you're too far from me. I need you close to me.
You stay on the pole. To the pole and then work her way back down to you.
But I was telling
her,
if
she right
come down upside down, I'm cool with it.
Thank you, G. As he takes a look at that. I don't know. I just pulled it up on your own Instagram page. But, you know, she teaches pole dancing and everything.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Lord, she's doing a split.
I don't even know which one I pulled up, but there's a lot of...
I'm talking about she's doing a better roll on that pole.
She's doing a split upside down.
That's a good one.
Cheers.
There we go.
Cheers.
We're going to make that happen. I'm gonna take a big look after that one.
And congratulations to you, though, on having such a huge song that everybody loves and the video and everything.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
I know you said you was going through kind of a rough time.
Yeah.
You know.
Still doing album process and everything. Just like, you know what I'm saying, with this fighting case, legal stuff, like, just everything. Family issues, all type of stuff. Mm-hmm. So, it took a lot for me to even, you know what I'm saying, keep going. And, man, it got to a point where I was just like, forget the music. I ain't even care about doing it. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So,
because this is your first LP, even though you've been putting out mixtapes and music and everything, this is like the feature length album. So it's a big deal.
You go first. It was like,
no, you go ahead.
No, I would say, and it's different for me because it's like every time I drop something, I go in the studio for like a day, day two, 3 days or something, and I rush to record. You know what I'm saying? I just go in that junk, geeked up, turn, and just going on back to back. And I got a whole mixtape ready. Come on, let's put it out. But with the album, it took time, like months and months and months. And I'm glad it took as long as it took. Mm-hmm. I probably would have been put it out, but, you know, but it's going to be great because I took my time. It's just like a nigga trying to hit for the fuck you real fast. And he hit it real fast. He, you know what I'm saying, like real fast.
That's a
pumps. Yeah, that's a mixtape you pump. But with this one right here, if he kiss you, I tongue kiss this one.
That's the album.
You know what I'm saying?
Shit, you made love.
Yeah, I made love. And I ain't had no rubber on.
Oh, shit.
So you know it's real.
But that baby ain't mine.
So you know it's real.
I'm just playing. Nah, but like, it's special.
Last time you were here, you had a girlfriend, too.
Yeah, I still do have one.
Okay, you still, I just want to make sure. Because when people say they went through some issues and stuff like
that. I
don't
go through them issues.
Okay.
Yeah, we don't have no problems.
It's the same girlfriend?
Yeah.
Good for you. Cheers to that. Yeah. Cheers to her.
How long you guys been together?
I don't want to talk about it.
Okay.
It's my personal life.
Every time somebody get at it,
Now we saw some video footage of you the other day in the club, and we had
hold
it
on,
in our group chat.
Hold on, pause for a second. I love the haircut on you too.
You do?
Yeah.
Oh my God! Thank you so much.
I like the haircut.
Angela told me that I look pretty today too, and you're the second
like the
person. Thank you. I appreciate you.
No, back to
thank
you,
so much.
So we had you in the group chat because we was looking at the video. You was on stage, and it looked like some girls was about to suck your dick on stage. We were like, he looks terrified. Because you tried to be cool with it at first,
and then you walked away.
But then you
I thought he was gonna pull it out. I wasn't sure.
Nah. See the thing is, my concerts be so lit. Like, I never forget when I used to perform booty. I used to like have to be like, I had to like, who want to buy a tour and come up here and twerk? Who ready to turn up? And they'll probably like free girl come up there and twerk or whatever. But like now, soon the beat drop, the whole gate break.
It's forget it. Yes.
So, bitches is rushing the stage.
I was just telling Angela about the reaction that I see. Like when I'm hosting a party and I'm in the club and they play your song, like people go nuts. It's
we gotta
doing
do a
good.
Party together.
Yeah,
I'm
do
telling
it.
You. Yeah, I'm hosting a party all the time. That's how I pay my bills. So let me know, please. Let me know.
Coming out on the 23rd.
Yeah, on 223. My album dropped 223, and I named it 223.
That's such a special number.
She has a very special. Number. She has her own special.
223 is amazing. It's
I thought you were about
numbers.
To do that beat again.
Nah, see.
No, 223 is a really good number. It means a lot to me, that number. And when we got off the highway today, we pulled behind the car, and the license plate in front of us. I took a picture. The license plate in front of us was the
223.
Y'all chosen ones.
You gotta get a driving. So. No, it wasn't me. It was the car in front of me.
So they can't push the album back, so I can fuck really up the whole title.
Nah, you can't ain't pushing them back. Nah. But it was special to me too, cause like even with me naming the album, I tried to name like real life things that was going on. And it took me 223 days to make my first $1 million. So that's why I named 223.
That's not that long. I just went
and plus two,
congratulations. Not that long at all. Congratulations on
and plus 223 my favorite show.
What is that?
That's gangster shit. I knew what he. I know what he's saying.
Okay. Oh, favorite show.
My favorite show. Yeah, I caught that.
Took me a minute to even
understand. Don't be in here fake drinking with us.
I'm
because we celebrate.
Hold on, I'm gonna give me another cup.
Oh shit! Woo!
All right, chug.
But like we in a frat.
They can't even believe it over there.
I love that Black Youngster.
He's gonna be
wanted
nice.
To come up here and
he's
turn
gonna
up
be
with
nice.
Us.
I was ready to get her.
Yeah.
Oh,
all right.
Nice.
Well, let's have some fun and let's talk about some things. All right, because Valentine's Day is coming up, and we wanted to talk about regifting. Thanks. We were watching what was happening on social media with Floyd Mayweather, and he had, you know, two of his exes arguing with his kid's mother.
Okay.
And the problem is with this chinchilla coat, right? Apparently, the ex, it used to be her chinchilla, and she's saying that the baby mom is wearing the chinchilla now. And it's the same coat, but it's a beautiful coat.
It got repossessed. He bought it for her and it got repoed. And then he gave it to the baby mom.
Now, what
she
do you think
kids.
About regifting something like that? Like, let's say.
Nah. I mean, don't get me wrong, Floyd, I know Floyd got plenty of money, so I know he ain't do it off just being cheap and not want to buy a coke. I mean, I think he did it just to be petty.
No, but what Floyd does,
he
the
repo man.
It is petty.
Yeah, but what Floyd does, when he gets his girlfriends whatever they want, he spoils them and gives them lavish gifts, and then when it's over, he takes them back.
It's understandable though,
because like as a man, all right, a really rich man who's worked hard and is successful, you get a woman all these beautiful things, beautiful jewelry, the top of the line bags, the best clothes, designer labels. And then you break up with her and she's on a date with the next man in your jewelry with your bag, your shoes, your designer
labels.
Well,
it's hers, really.
Right?
No, you bought it.
That's called a gift.
But that's, I understand why. Like, I get it. You know, I get it.
See, look,
that can happen.
With me personally, I take it as, like she said, it's cool. Like, me personally, I won't take nothing back from them. Nah.
Because what you going
to
do with
nah,
it?
You going to give it to your baby mama.
But the thing is, I want to take it back because the thing is, I feel like he probably took it back because the person he bought it from, she probably a little thought box anyway. But the thing is, I want to have to take nothing back because I ain't going to buy from nobody that I feel like don't deserve.
Right.
I agree with that too.
So I ain't going to buy nothing from no thought anyway. Like, you got to. Put in some work. Do some push-ups. You know what I'm saying?
Push-ups on the dick or
yeah,
just
so
push-ups?
Like, so what that man said, you deserve it. Whatever I got you, you deserve it. Automatically you did something for me to really do this for you. So if something go wrong, you can take it with you.
Well, ladies, if a guy gave you a re-gift, but let's just say it was something really nice because like you said, you know, he takes those things back. So let's just say somebody gave you a car that was his ex's.
What, Scorpion, get over here.
Get over here.
Get over here. Oh, no, I'm talking about like clothes and shoes. We need to cars, houses, and all that. No. Horse, you got to come on back.
That's what I'm saying.
No.
Like, you know, I've been with a guy who gave me a lot of nice things, and when we broke up, he took them back, and I was happy to give them back.
Wait, what if he cheated, though, or what if he did something wrong?
Still come back.
What? You fucked up. What she did?
Nah, see, this is like I said, like clothes, shoes, anything on your body. It's just like when this is the kid everything. Let me get up in the couch on this one. Let me take my shoes off.
No, the guy let me
take my shoes off. Oh, yes. I got to get comfortable.
Everybody look, take your shoes off.
Check this one out. So if the IRS come and they come and you owe them some money, they come and collect their money or whatever, you ain't got it, and they come take everything, they can take everything from you except what's on you.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Do you know that?
Right.
I didn't know that.
Right. I didn't know that either.
No, they tell you. They tell you. Take a few things. They tell you take a few things that you can hold in your hands and you could go.
You ain't got it on you. Whatever ain't on you, I need that back. You know what I'm saying? They watch on you. You cool with that? This coke, all their shoes, but all their other than cars, houses, I need all that back.
Yeah.
It's just like the IRS. If they can do it, why can't we come do it?
And the IRS.
We come to collect.
Lord. That's petty.
Like I said, I was with a guy who bought me a lot of nice things and took the stuff back. And he let me keep a few things. He let me keep like my shoes and my clothes.
How do you choose?
No, I know a guy that takes shoes back.
No,
he ain't take them back from me.
Shoes?
He famous too.
Nah,
I like this person. We in good spirits, me and this person. So I'm not going to put him out there. I'll tell y'all later. But
you know,
I know he broke up with this girl and he went to her house and came out with duffel bags full of bags and
shoes. What are you doing with these
jewelry
shoes?
Listen, and him and my guy at the time were friends. So he called me like, yo, what size you wear? I don't want none of that bitch's repo red bottom.
Damn. What her dirty toe prints?
What about
the bags?
I didn't want none of it.
What if it was like a Rolex?
It was a Rolex.
Nah,
with a Birkin,
I might have taken
shit,
that.
But I didn't take none of it. I didn't want none of it. Because I know the girl. Like, should I look like walking around with her Chanel bag? Like, nah, I'm good.
Me personally, I only would do it if I know what type of woman I'm dealing with. You got some women like, man, I promise you, like, dudes don't understand. Females can you can find a faithful female quicker than you can find a faithful dude.
Of course.
Like,
absolutely.
Facts.
Big
so thing
fact.
Is,
glad you know that.
Yeah, mm-hmm. But the thing is, it's like I don't get it because it's like, if I know I'm dealing with you and I know what type of person, like I know you're a good person, like I know, because there's certain things you ain't even do for me when I met you. Like when I tried to put up at your house, you ain't even let me put up because you ain't want me to know where you and the homeboy stayed. So if I know, if you took me through a rough time, I might let you keep it.
Wait, you said where you and your homeboy.
No, I'm saying like, they said
like she was in a relationship.
They said you in a relationship and I'm dating you and
that's already wrong.
No, I'm just saying. But
what happened?
Let's say if she talked to somebody.
No, but you know, like he said, he respected her for the precautions that she took and the ways that she went.
She ain't let me put up and see you.
You know she's not gonna do that to you. Right, you know she's not gonna do that to you. So
you know what I'm saying? It's just certain stuff you didn't do.
No, and I give that advice to a lot of people too. Like, don't ever do something in the beginning of a relationship that is out of your character. You know what I mean? Because people remember.
Be all the way
so wait,
through.
You were the side guy?
Nah. Based on what I'm saying, if I'm dating you, and this go back, with me taking something back. Like if I'm dating you, and I'm dating you, and I know, I mind like you taking me through a little real time. Like you dating somebody else or something, but got something going on. You know what I'm saying? Okay. You live in life, but you live with some dude or something, and he bought you a car. When you put up on me, you make sure I don't get in that car.
Right.
You make sure I don't lean on it. You make sure you come right in.
No, it's certain characteristics. Guys notice.
You know what I'm saying? Like you make sure you make sure you.
I respect the fact that I'm cheating on my boyfriend.
You tell me like you make sure I don't never say nothing to disrespect him or
this is crazy.
Don't even bring him. Don't do that. Like you know what type of woman you dealing with.
Okay. No, I know exactly what you mean.
Yeah. Like, so she's cheating.
You gotta have morals.
If you cheating with respect,
cheat with respect.
No, but you know,
bitch, if you can cheat with respect, you can keep that.
If you gonna cheat clean,
but that's some hood shit because you know, like a guy will admire that you're not putting him in front of the next man's house and everything like that, because you know she's still like she's still making sure he don't get set up and things like that. You know?
Listen, I'm not gonna lie, I had sex with my ex boyfriend before he left the girl he was with in the bed that they slept in together.
This
I ain't shit, but.
I ain't shit. Guess I'm what not he was doing.
Yeah.
I ain't shit.
It's really him that ain't shit because, like, that's not my girlfriend. I wasn't in a relationship.
He ain't shit. And
that
you ain't shit
his
too.
Crib.
Because you knew.
You ain't shit too.
He's
never
going to
be. No, one movie come out, they bring out part two on it. He ain't shit part one, and you ain't shit part two.
Listen, I didn't cheat on nobody. I wasn't in a relationship. That
but
was.
But you knew
her.
That was that woman's bed.
That wasn't her bed. He paid for that bed. She ain't had no money.
And she slobbed on that bed and everything.
She didn't have a bed.
I know wrong. I know wrong.
Her DNA was in it.
It's like this with me. Like it's two things. Like it's. I don't know where you can keep it. Keep things. Something I give you, if you respect it and you respectful. Like I'm respected and respectful. Mm-hmm. So. And like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
You took them the main words. Like, all people want to do is be respected and want to be respectful.
I understand that.
So, you know what I'm saying?
Respectfully, he left her, and then we ended up in a relationship for like
Now, what if she's wearing some jewelry that her ex got her? Like, you know, she got a nice watch, nice chain.
Somebody, if I'm fucking with you.
But it was like before you. But it's a nice chain. She loves it. She wears it all the time.
Yeah, go take that off.
No, like I was even saying with the guy who took his stuff back. I was happy to give him his stuff back because any man that I'm with that respects himself is not going to want me to be wearing the next man's stuff.
Around the next man.
Right, exactly.
So with, but it's not
I
sure.
gloss you up it's and now you over here flossing with
like
him.
Like but my ex, mine. My ex, he made me he made me get rid of all my bags and bought me new ones that the next
See,
man
but
bought
that's
me.
Different. When are you buying it? New jewelry? Yeah, like
nah, I'm gonna tell you the game. I'm gonna get this how you know if a nigga really like you.
What?
For all the ladies out there, this how you know if a nigga really like you. When you leave,
let me take my shoes off.
I swear for God, niggas love to wait till another female, another man get a female and they bought him, boss him up and get him, you know, get their life in order. Then they automatically just want them bad. Like, bro, you been seeing me all the time, you ain't been woman?
Mm-hmm.
So the thing is, how you know if a written man really wants you when you go to him, even if you got something? I ain't got nothing. Nothing at all. Mm-hmm. Then you see how he react then. See if he gonna rebuy you that science shit. If he can't rebuy you that science shit,
no, I agree. Like if your man sees that you wearing an old bag all the time and he don't buy you a new bag, like he don't really fuck with you like that. Especially if he's a millionaire.
Any real nigga that you fucking with and you leave a nigga that's getting money, and you get with a nigga. I ain't even gonna get money or not. When you automatically get with a new nigga, you starting over. So that means you starting off new jewelry, new cars, new houses. New lifestyle. Nigga,
okay, I can see that.
I agree with that.
What are you about? What's you? Cause look, my last nigga, you know, I was cool now. I ain't had to leave that now.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying? No, it's okay. It's okay. But you know what I'm saying? Like, go to a nigga and tell me you ain't got shit. Cause I'm gonna tell you the reason how I learned it. When I was young, when I was broke, I used to come around, man, talk about my problem, like, man, I need to do this, man, fucked up, woo the woo. Man, them hoes didn't want me. But you know what I'm saying? Them niggas didn't want to tell me what to do to get no money. But as soon as I came around lying like I got some, everybody want to.
He said lying.
They got everything. You know what I'm just saying? Like, you got to, in order to get something, you got to act like you got it or you got to have it.
Fake it till you make it.
That's what we say. Okay. It's
crazy. I don't like fake it till you make it, though. I be telling people not to fake it.
Come from the hood, you got to fake it. You got to, like, where I grew up.
It helps you make it sometimes.
Yeah.
I think it's
where
true.
I grew up, it was rough.
But I think there's so much beauty in struggle.
Yeah.
Not to everybody. They'd be like, that bum ass bitch.
But coming from where I come
from. Yeah, I agree with that. You can't look project. Broke.
They're going to be like, this bum ass bitch, I ain't about to be super save a hoe, like figure it out.
See, when you tell them you fucked up, they're going to make sure you stay fucked up.
I could definitely say when I was younger, I faked it till I make it. Like now I'm on this whole thing, like anything that I'm doing, it's like in real life. You know what I mean? That's my new shit.
No, when I was in the streets, I was swinging. So check me out. I probably put up, when I ain't have nothing going on, I probably put up. Man, I got a play down the street, bro. Somebody trying to get such woo woo. And now I'm trying to make the play woo woo. Then nobody will never want to give me that money, go get it. They won't never give me the drugs, go get it. But guess what, though? Now I got the junk now, bro. You know, I got you right now. What you trying to get? You know what I'm saying? Give
me, and you'll make it happen.
Go get my little cut, bro. Hey, bro, give me such a real fast. Boom, go cut them. All right, boy, come back for some more.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, you got to fake it. Like, come from where I come from, you got to know how to finesse it.
Yeah, definitely.
They going to keep you broke. When you say you broke, they love to hear that. I'm going to get with you, bro.
Oh, she's broke. She's okay. She'll be broke.
Man, come on. They
but she had me broke. She looked like she doing good broke to me. So I'm going to keep my money in my pocket and leave her broke ass doing what she doing.
Now,
she's still going to suck your dick.
We're going to have some fun with Black Youngster because we need you to translate some things for us, okay?
Just do it.
Because guys do and say certain things and we don't know what they really mean. So you're going to tell us what it really means when guys say and do certain things. Okay. If a guy says to you, I do want to be committed, but just not right now.
I respect it, brother.
But what does he mean?
What does he mean?
Hey, y'all been getting me fucked up out here. I'm going.
Ran that shit.
I'm only gonna answer this question because I got a mama and I got cousins and stuff, females, and I want them to have.
Don't you
be
in here snitching on what men say.
They gotta get you.
I'm saying this only gonna answer the question, but what they mean is. I want to keep fucking bitches and shit, baby.
That's what I said.
That's what I think it means.
I promise you, later on, we're going to be together.
I'm going to get right back.
But y'all never probably going to be together.
I was just fucking them girls. I was going to get right back. What they're saying is I want you to be faithful to me. I don't want you to sleep around with anybody
else. That's also
what
else
you cannot have sex with other people.
It means we in a relationship.
If you catch me having sex with other people, you can't be mad and you still can't have sex with other people.
You have a boyfriend. I don't think that is like, don't have sex with nobody else. It's like, you're my pussy.
That's what it is.
I feel like it's like, you're my pussy because I'm giving you hope that eventually one day we'll be together. So it's like, you're going to keep giving him pussy because it's like, all right, one day me and him going to be together. But he's still fucking whoever.
Yeah.
He's fucking anybody and everybody.
Well, I'm going to tell you something I learned, though. See, I like it's about what you want in life. It's a woman. It's about what you want in life. Like it don't even matter what the nigga doing. Like what you want. You know what I'm saying? Like, what you waking up trying to be? What you trying to accomplish in life? And I'm keeping it 100. It's cool for a dude to go do it, but it really ain't cool for a woman to go do it.
Right.
It ain't.
That's what guys think.
I agree with it though.
My judge women's off the dudes that like I can be around you. I like you in real life, like it's a person.
Mm-hmm.
But I can meet somebody that you probably date now, probably ain't fit. Oh, what is she doing that?
She kind of whack now.
She yeah.
Right. Changed the whole
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so
right?
I judge women's off the type of dudes they deal with and they date.
Mm-hmm.
Off the rip. You know
but we judge guys like that too.
Absolutely.
Like sometimes you meet
you
a guy and you talking to him and then you be like, that's who the fuck he was fucking with?
Mm-hmm. I used to be like
can't
that.
Do that with
he's
no
nasty.
Guy.
Why not?
I used to be like
dick
that.
Ain't got no ass.
Exactly. Like I used to be like that. Also,
it has one eye.
It does have one eye.
But that motherfucker, Fetty Wap. No disrespect. One time to Fetty Wap, though, man. No disrespect, man.
One time to Fetty Wap.
No disrespect. One time to Fetty
Wap. He's drunk. He's had one drink.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
He had a whole cup of champagne. He threw it back like a shot.
All them babies and kids. I think of Fetty Wap. I'm just like,
man, pussy got ass and lips. You know what you're doing.
Okay, I used to judge guys off of the girls that they dated. Like it could be a total deal breaker for me.
If a guy dated a
dusty ass bitch, mm-hmm. like it could, but then I started dating a real one, and he made me realize that, sometimes you gotta fuck with a dusty ass bitch on a dusty ass night. You know what I mean?
But what if it's consistent?
And I don't think it's acceptable, but I don't feel like you could judge off of the dusty bitches.
You can't
that
fuck
he's been
no
with.
Dusty bitch.
Wait, because so I'm not gonna lie,
have
my
ever, have you ever fucked dusty bitches?
Dusty bitches?
No.
Rasta.
Never, ever, not when you were younger. You ain't never fucked
no
dusty
bitches.
See, when you younger, you.
I'm taking all the dusty bitches. When I was younger?
When you was younger, I'm sure.
Nine out of 10 of the girls. In the
when you was faking it till you made it.
I was fucking dusty, rusty, crusty. I would ask you too.
What age did you stop fucking dusty bitches?
Y'all could have dusty crusty ass.
I mean,
I want to know what age you stopped fucking
dusty
bitches.
I say me personally.
Last year.
No, I say about 15.
Okay. All right.
I'm gonna tell you what I hate the most. Ooh. Hold on, let's squish this
when
story.
These dusty bitches come up to
let's
you.
Talk about the girls. Let's talk about everybody that's trying to be healthy. Man,
shout out
I
to
hate
the juice
a
bar.
Healthy. I hate a woman that want to be so healthy to where you forget to chew your gum.
What?
Man, it's like all the healthy women, all they do is drink water. They just don't know this shit make your breath even more stinky. Like, y'all gotta stop. Y'all gotta find some shit to put in your mouth.
You so healthy, your breath stink.
You know what's really bad is that we're actually gonna be doing a detox next week.
All the healthy bitches breath stink.
I never did one before, right? But when you read the instructions for the detox, it says that it's gonna make you stink. It's gonna make your breath stink, and it's gonna make you have a vaginal discharge that could be greenish, and that you should wear a pad.
What? Next.
I just wanted to say that. We can get back to what we were talking about. I don't want
the green juice coming
out
my pussy. I ain't see that part of the detox list.
I'm glad I ain't got to do that detox.
So all the healthy women out there, please, I'm telling you now, you just be fine. Them niggas don't even want to tell you because you look good. You come with the outfit on, your booty, booty, booty all out. You know what I'm saying? They don't want to tell your brother really funky. No, you pretty teeth with your brother funky.
That's nasty.
Man,
will you give her some
audit? It's like all the healthy girls I see, it's like the girls that ain't healthy. Brush smell good because they don't eat all the shit they need to make sure they brush smell good. They don't care how much fat it got in there. Mine, the healthy shit gotta stop today. Real talk.
Eat some fried chicken.
Now, do girls in the past ever now be like, oh, you know, I used to mess with black youngster, like, you know, putting it out there, and now that you all.
Nah.
That's my old work.
Yeah.
Nah, because
it used to eat it.
It's just like claim your daddy and he don't claim you back. I'm not the pappy. I'm not the pappy.
That's fucked up.
Hey, I'm talking about, look, hey, for real, I'm not going to claim you back. I'm not the pappy.
You know, but I'm sure that there's some girls in the past that look crazy now that you like, damn.
Oh, yeah, they sad.
They
sad. They sick. You got to think about it because when I'm coming up, I used to tell my dream. I used to be telling my over and over what I'm going to do, how I'm going to do it. I ain't going to go like this, going to go like that. And like I told somebody before, not all the time with somebody, if you tell her something and it don't become true or something, she didn't lie to you. People take it the wrong way, like, ah, he lying. Whole time, it's just my dream that it ain't come true.
It ain't happened yet.
So the thing is, I ain't tell you no lie. I told you my dream.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I thought they were gonna happen, and they were my dream. I dreamed about it. It just didn't happen. You know what right. I'm saying? So when it finally happened, now them whores. Hate it.
Motherfucking whores.
And to be honest, I can't even lie. A lot of people, like a lot of females you date, they ain't got no good things to say about me, though.
Oh, that's nice. I ain't he never did come in here with gifts for all of us.
So yeah. He did. So nice.
Try to be nice.
Very nice. We appreciate it.
What does it mean when a guy says this? I've been so busy. I'm sorry. I just haven't had time.
I respect it.
Because some people will say, any guy that really cares about what you will make time if it's
hell nah. I'm going to tell you something, though. I'm going to tell you what I learned. My grandma, she's always tell my granddad, like, you always working. You ain't doing this. You need to do this and then come home. I want to have dinner. He just worked every day. The week he took a week off. So, you know, when you take off, you're not getting paid. Excuse me. You're not getting paid. You off.
She like, go back to work.
That week off, if some shit happens she wanted to do, and I promise you, man, when I tell you she hit this man with a bat upside his motherfucking head when he told her, he said, I ain't been to work. You asked me to take off, I've been here with you. Man, she smacked this man so fucking hard. So I knew then. No matter what you say or do, man, go to work. Because as soon as you take out work and you ain't doing shit, you sitting at home, I ain't making no money. Our female, they get too comfortable, want to overrule y'all. Nigga, you ain't doing shit anyway. You know what I'm saying? Like, they do all type of shit. I'd rather be working. Like, I look at it like, we can get this shit a time. We going to be together forever. Let's give it a time. All right, let's go hard 5 years, then let's calm down. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Don't do me like this right now while this shit going good for me. You see me if they go get this motherfucking, you know, I think about it, you know what I'm saying? I get $5,000-$5,000 a show. So you can only get this shit 3-4 times a weekend. So don't forget to stop. Go not go get that to go do this.
But she could come with you.
No. I'm gonna tell you why. I'm gonna tell you why.
No.
In it.
No.
Absolutely. In it. Pause for a second. Tip Drill just walked in.
You want
in.
Some too, old man?
No.
That was too funny.
He said no.
You want some too, old man?
No. Hey, for real. You squeeze right here.
Yeah, come on.
Right here, we got a mic for you.
We got a mic for you. Hello.
What's up?
Hey, Will.
why they call you Tip Drill?
Dance like the girls in the Tip Drill video.
I don't believe it.
Oh,
I know all about it.
Oh my God, you guys don't know each other.
I just seen GD video. I don't know now.
y'all don't know each other. You don't know Tip Drill.
No, we got like
mutual. I seen him on TV before.
No, but I know Tip Drill.
But you ain't see that booty.
Yeah.
That big old booty.
I ain't seen him twerking that booty booty on TV. I ain't seen you twerking that booty booty on TV.
Not yet.
All right, so what were you saying about why you can't bring her?
Because the thing is, like, I look at it like this. Me, I'm the type of person, like if I don't take my... A woman should not want to be around a club environment. Like, you know what's going on in my show.
She could be in the hotel waiting.
That's cool. That's cool all day. But the thing is, I kind of like try to do it like, I want to miss you. Let me miss you. Let me go.
Like, I missed you while I was performing. I'm back.
See, the thing is, I want that real miss you. Uh-huh. I don't want to come after the show and give you no lazy, handicapped dick.
I feel like if a guy tells you that he's busy, he could really be busy. I mean, if he's busy for a month, then you might want to.
Or he could be just busy for you. Or whoever he's
talking about. When you're dealing with a boss nigga like me, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like, I'm going to take my woman on a vacay every time I got a day off. We ain't going to just spend it in no movies or no club or no. You know what I'm saying? We're going to go on a vacay. We're going to go out the country. Go do something you want to do. You know what I'm saying?
But like, not every guy has a life like you. So what about before you was going on tour and doing these records? Have you ever said to a woman, like, she's like, hey, daddy, I miss you. I'm busy, bitch. Like,
I know, when you're dating a guy, you know what kind of lifestyle. Like, if you're dating him, you know he's a rapper. You know
right, it's obviously. Like,
if you're dating a lawyer... Maybe he has a lot of meetings. Maybe he doesn't. You know what I mean?
Maybe he just don't want to see you.
But if you're dating a guy who, and you know his schedule, he has a 9-to-5 schedule, you know what I mean? And he might not be too busy for you. He might just be...
My advice to anybody ain't got no money, if in order to make sure everything cool, bro, go take massage lessons. They love massages.
you could just learn on YouTube.
I know ladies my bitch love me because she rubbed my feet.
Oh, like, you did say that.
One massage me, you got me for life.
I'm not going to hold you. The only guy who feet I ever massaged, like, I really did love him. Like, not no more. But at the time, like,
did
I would
suck his toes, too?
I did suck his toes. We was in the tub. It wasn't on no. He was walking around all day. Put the foot in my mouth.
Don't make no scream.
That's
for
nasty. Listen,
no, I'm gonna get
had
it.
I said I did it.
He already took his shoes off.
Right.
He's getting prepared.
Ugly feet and word goes to youngster.
But Tipter, how do you know you're in love with somebody? You rub feet and suck toes.
I do.
Thank you.
Y'all trying to make it look like I'm an alien. If I kiss you, that mean I'm in love with you. Because I can't kiss. I got to really, like, fuck with you to kiss you.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I feel on it.
But don't people kiss like before they do
out.
Other stuff?
Yeah, I like to make out. Like, I might just want to have a make out session in the middle of a date. Like, hey, you want to make out?
Nah,
I like
making out
ain't certain people. I feel like you can't just kiss everybody.
You can't kiss everybody.
You got to kiss.
But can you fuck somebody and not kiss them?
Yes.
Let me tell you what my DJ Artifacts told me. They don't make you a bad person.
It doesn't make you a bad person if you have sex without kissing.
They don't make you a bad person at all.
But where's the passion?
Well, maybe that's not that with that.
All right, just for instance, when a guy's on top of me, right? When a guy's on top of me, like I'm all hands and rubbing his back and sucking on his neck and licking him and telling him I like it. You know what I mean? Like,
but what if you just woke up in the morning? And this is going down.
Oh no, but I brush my teeth before
but
I go to
sleep. But what if you ain't get to that point? He's just putting the dick in and you just
I brush my teeth before I go to sleep, so I'm ready to make out fresh in the morning. Like my should be
eat
nice
some gum
in
first.
The morning.
Eat some gum. Yeah, because we know you don't
I like make out kisses. I love morning breath make out kisses. I like that shit.
I would knock that shit off.
I like morning breath kisses. I love it. I'll be turning around to him and I'll be like, give me a morning breath kiss. He'd be like, okay. All
right, let's decode this, Black Youngster. What does it mean?
Hey, but if you rubbing his back and shit, if he let you touch his ass, he gay.
No, he doesn't. He be like,
That's not true.
Shit. That is not true.
Now, if he twerks it, it's on booty. He might.
Then he gay. Yes, fuck.
He gay.
That booty.
All right, now here's the next one. Decode this for us. All right, if a guy tells you, well, you know, I don't want to post you on IG because it's not for the world to see.
I respect it, man.
You respect it all. He's spinning you.
He respect every line. I respect that game.
You hear me? I respect it, man. With everything you mean.
It's all you. Angela, how you get all his lines?
Right.
I respect it, man.
Ange, pull all your cards. You respect it all.
No. See, I'm going to tell you, though. The reason I respect that man, I mean, I look at it like, who knows? Maybe he a gangster. Maybe he did something he ain't supposed to been done before. Maybe it's some happy part trying to just keep you safe.
There you go.
But he got pictures of himself and his kids and all that other shit, though. How about that?
You know.
Right. So, ladies, in our heads, what does that mean if your man won't post you on IG?
He got 10,000 other bitches or at least one.
He don't want somebody to see.
That makes me happy because that means I don't got to post him on IG. So we even.
But you got something to hide then.
Nah, I don't got nothing to hide. The thing is, as soon as bitches find out who I'm fucking with, he becomes a hot commodity. You know what I mean?
Facts.
So, girl, see, it could be a regular guy from around the corner, even though I don't date regular guys from around the corner. But if I did, I post up with him, they're going to think, oh, he must have some good dick. He must have some money.
Facts.
He must be fired
because
Stephanie's with him.
Right.
So it just works better. Look, the love of my life is FaceTime.
But he has to have enough respect for you.
Tongue kiss him through the phone.
Not to do
anything. Show me how I got you a tongue kiss.
I'm going
to
email and say, baby, I'm working.
Tongue kiss through the phone.
I'm working.
Tongue kiss through the phone.
That's all I see.
Tongue kiss through the phone. We want to go. That's what he says. So let's see.
Everybody be quiet.
Yeah. Don't everybody be quiet.
Everybody be quiet.
Look, it's not connecting anyway.
Oh, what are you listening to? What are you listening to?
I'm going to call you back. I'm at work. I'm going to call you.
She want to give you a tongue kiss.
Kiss me through the phone.
Now I have to answer that because he's psycho, and if I didn't answer it, he was gonna think that I was fucking
with
somebody.
He think go fuck somebody because you not ready when he ready.
That booty.
Cheat on him tonight. Cause he gonna cheat on you.
Oh my god, I'm about
that
to
big old she leaving now. You done fucked up.
Don't play with me.
She out. Bye,
No. But what was I saying before that?
Oh, shit, she got
thrown off. She don't even know what's going on. Hey, we talking about
cheat on him tonight.
A guy not
no, I'm not gonna cheat on him.
If you don't gotta
push him. Wait, what was I saying?
The IG.
You glad they help post you because then you don't got posts. No, but like I said, please, even this guy that is here, the one that I was just talking about, like, I didn't even know anything about him when I first got with him. After a couple bitches found out that, like, it's like a competition thing. Like, for me, the best relationships are the ones that nobody knows about. And I don't think that you, like I said, there's a, Avion said this, there's a difference between keeping someone, you know, a secret, like, and to the general people, like your circle and around,
like your
and there's a difference between somebody who's just hiding you, keeping you in a closet. You know, that's just they don't fuck with you like that. But you don't have to tell Instagram about your relationship. I mean, your friends and your family.
I'm gonna keep it 100. I don't mean to cut you off. Mm-hmm. I don't believe in the Instagram shit because, like, when I was younger, I went through mistakes of having a female around dudes I'm cool with. Then I look up. Months later, I ain't even cool with them no more. Now they know.
I see you cleared up your whole IG too. You cleared it all up.
Yeah.
There's only like 40 pictures on
it. Why?
Yeah,
I'm stopping.
And I feel like with guys, especially famous guys, like, you're really protecting your girl when you're not posting her up.
Facts.
Because you have people, your fans, your stalkers. Facts. You know, people at the blogs watching you now. You have people putting their negative opinions towards your relationship.
People
you
do
don't
be
really
lying too
that.
And being like, you know, he fucked my homegirl. Like,
yeah, they lie. Every time you hear is a lie.
I'm not a
big. A lot of truths.
And I'm not a big celebrity. I'm not a big Hollywood star, super famous, but I am a popular girl. So if I post you up on my IG, you're going to get a million people looking at you. You know what I mean? It's a lot of eyes.
Uh-huh. Well, don't bring your girl around Tip Drill. That's all I have to say.
Oh, good.
She'll snatch
that thing right on up. She will snatch that bitch up so quick.
Would you be mad if your girl, like, got with Tip Drill and they had a little something-something? Because I'm watching Love & Hip Hop.
Look at her face, because I can see her face over here.
Gunplay is kind of turned on by it, because his girlfriend, Tidrill, wanted...
He had no choice.
I'm going to keep it...
It was already over.
Oh, my God. Gunplay is on Love & Hip Hop. I didn't even know.
Miami. Shout out to Gunplay. I met with Gunplay.
Shout out to Gunplay, man.
I met him one time.
Gunplay.
He was a good dude.
He cool.
Yeah.
So
like she,
I'm sorry,
she
guys. I just moved into a building and I get free Wi-Fi in the building.
The big old
so
coochie.
I don't need cable anymore, so I don't have TV.
Pop that coochie.
That's the truth.
That big old coochie.
I haven't watched TV in like 3 months.
I feel like I'm gonna just walk around saying that shit all day.
They've been doing this all day.
My snap before he came. Like, that's my shit. Like,
I gotta make you a song, a special song just for this show.
Oh,
for
my God. Lip service song.
I'm gonna go in studio and make a song just for this show.
Oh, my God, please.
I gotta shout y'all out ASAP.
So now, what would you do if your girl got with Tip Drill? Would that bother you?
Me personally, it all depends on what type of girl. That wouldn't bother me at all. Oh, no.
Okay, I just want to make sure.
Yeah, but some females don't like even other females. Some females are like, you know, sucking dick by themselves.
But does it? I'm one of those females.
I'm always down for some,
you know what I'm saying, threesome action.
You said always.
Always.
Tag team.
Like, yeah.
I said that a threesome is limitations. Like, it could be a foursome or a fivesome or a sixsome.
Or octumsome.
Four is my signal.
You see?
If I see it right.
Signature.
Now, let me ask you this, ladies. Would you be mad if you were having a threesome with your man and he busted a nut with the other chick and not you?
No, yes. That's a turn on.
What?
I like to watch. Like, that turns me on watching. And, like, him finishing with her, that wouldn't make me mad. Like, that's going to turn me on.
Mm-hmm. I don't want to see her
really
my
about
man.
That life.
I just don't want to see my man.
Yeah, it don't really matter to me. I wouldn't get mad. That's what we here for.
Tutu.
It wouldn't really matter.
Tutu.
That takes a lot of confidence.
I got you. Whenever you need me, just, you know.
No, and that takes a lot of confidence. You know what I mean? To because if you think about it, your man's getting nuts on you all the time. Like,
right. He probably is. That's what we here for. Listen, you brought this bitch in here to do some work. Bitch, do some work.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Couldn't work.
What if he was fucking the other girl and was like, this is the best pussy I ever had?
Now, see, that's going too far. Ooh. I don't even want him kiss her. Don't kiss her. Don't kiss her. Kiss her. You got to use a condom. Fuck her and let's keep it moving.
You got to knock that bitch teeth out if he's saying that's the best pussy. And it's the best punch in the face this bitch ever had, too.
Nah, I was having a threesome with a couple before and the girl got mad. She shut the whole thing down in the middle.
Damn, in the middle?
Did he say your pussy was the best?
No, but she said, I don't like the way you fucking her. You ain't never fucking
been
me
fucking
like that. He was
before.
Too into it. Oh. And she was like, I don't like the way you fucking her. Like, she really shut the whole thing down.
Wait, why are you pointing at me?
Because that's how you're supposed to do your drop.
Toot. You gotta put your hand up like the Black Power fist. You can't just point like that. We gotta be a unity.
She got mad.
Yeah, she got mad. She shut the whole thing down.
What you was doing to the man?
I mean, I was doing what I do.
You know, she killed the man before.
Tell me what you was doing.
Gigi killed the man before.
He wants to know.
You killed the man?
Yeah.
He died.
She was having sex with him, and he fucking died. He's dead.
Is this a true story?
He died while in the moment.
The pussy killed him.
He had a heart attack that same night.
He had a heart attack while we was fucking.
Yeah.
She got the killer pussy.
And then he died.
Get the fuck out of here.
No, that's true. No, that's true.
I see you at the corner of my eye.
No, that's true. He did that. He had a heart attack, and then eventually he died.
I hate that we joke about this man's death.
I'm talking about, hey, Nine, that pussy murder, Inc.
Room, baby. Hey, what a way to go.
Room, baby. And it puts murder in.
Room is murder.
He died. May he rest in peace. I didn't kill him, though. All right.
Black Yang said, what does it mean when a guy says, we're planning a guy's trip, no one's bringing their ladies?
Prostitute vacation.
We're planning a guy's trip.
A guy's trip. Just you and your boys. You can't come.
The girls can't come.
You got respected. Why you want to be my friends away? My friends, your old friends.
But you know what my thing is?
What if it's not a boys trip?
What if it's all girls, you take your boyfriend?
Angela would do something like that for sure.
She's coming on an all-girls trip.
Nah, you got to let the guys. Let the guys be the guys.
My nigga coming on an all-girls trip,
I'm
going to
tell you why I say it. For example,
right? Stay in the room.
This big kid, everything. Well, female, what y'all don't understand is like, it don't be that the dude don't want you to be around. It's just like, let's say if I'm going on a gas trip and you my girlfriend, I'm saying, all right, boom, if I'm going on a gas trip, baby boo, I don't want you to come though. And you be like, you want to come. But let's say I bring you. And my four, five guys I got around me, they going to be trying to be too extra nice. They going to be uncomfortable.
Mm-hmm.
I'm cool. I got pussy. My woman here, I'm for the tongue.
My boys.
Like, yeah. But my boys is like, they can't even do what they want to do. And they can't bring all the thoughts they want to bring to fuck for themselves because they know I got a real woman in this house.
But that's okay. Hard because then if the guy is
bringing I do get what he's saying.
Guys, when guys say we're going on a boys trip, it means usually the trip is Vegas, Miami. Those
Brazil,
are the cheap ones.
No, DR.
Wait, listen. Dominican Republic, Colombia, Brazil. Those are all prostitute
always
locations.
Dominican Republic.
It's a prostitute vacation. Yeah, they're going to hire bitches and
we
have sex.
Dubai and shit, though.
That's what boys trips are, prostitute vacations.
But please be clear, you're bringing bitches back if you ain't got, because you just said, look, you just said on a trip you would have your pussy, your woman. So that means you need that on your trip.
I don't remember
saying
it.
So if she's not there, yeah, you did. And you did.
I plead the fifth.
Nah, since that,
I'm going to tell you something. What women don't really realize, like niggas is busy, really don't be having time to fuck like you think they do.
What?
Because you think they find me
on vacation on a boy trip.
I promise to God,
vacation.
Look, you gotta maybe you need to watch out for the guys that's around the artists.
Mm-hmm.
Besides the artists, because the artists can't just go. I ain't just go to no female and try to. You know what I'm saying?
No, like, I know. Honestly, when you're dating an entertainment guy, when you're dating somebody who is a artist or a athlete or something like that, they always got their side friends. Okay. Those people are the ones you really need to watch for.
For example,
because the main person, the boss, is always busy. Sure, but it's those that are influencing
bringing the bitches around.
Exactly. Them
influencers. He's always busy, too busy to fuck and
never,
get some pussy in
never,
his bed.
No, never, never, busy. Never busy. Never, never busy. But they blame it on them. They make them. They the ones booking the flights. They the ones bringing the bitches. Like, yo, I got a whole room for the girls.
Just think about it. All I'm saying is, for example, everybody that come, every artist that come to New York, do you think they got time to stick their dick in somebody?
Yes.
No.
Yes.
You know Don't you know how tired a person be when they come up with
these? Please, oh my God, for artists, all they gotta do is tell a girl, meet me in the room, fuck the bitch for 30 minutes, and then be like, oh, it was nice seeing you, baby.
That's it.
All right, but in Black Youngster's defense, I be tired as fuck. I get up every morning.
Angela, you're a whole woman. different. It's different.
I could understand how a guy would be tired too.
My nigga, he got bitches in every state. Not you, but I'm saying an artist.
Not me.
Because I don't know. Not me. Not you.
Not Black Youngster.
But like an artist will have bitches in every state that they've been talking to for months. Now he coming to New York. That bitch is coming to suck his dick.
No, please. A lot of these girls have no morals, no rules to life. They just hype off of the person that they dealing with. And the nigga will be like, listen, I got 25 minutes. You down? And they'll be like, yup.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna
literally kick the girl out of 25 minutes.
I'm gonna tell you another thing too. A lot of times I put my right hand to the good Lord. My artists be so busy, like, bruh, to my busy, like, I'm tired. When I tell you, I've been up for days and days and days. I don't even know how I'm still alive.
Like, I'm literally, feel you.
Like,
because...
bro, what a sleep at.
I remember you know there, I remember there
still
was
not
one
gonna
time
pass up on 5 minutes
before I bought my house.
Hello?
I worked 30 days in a row nonstop. Got up at 4 a.m. in the
Angela,
morning.
Please, went to, well, do not back him.
Can I finish?
Do not back him.
30 days in a row. Got up at 4 a.m. Went to work in the morning. Worked all day. Hosted at night because I was about to buy a house and I wanted to stack up my money. And I was so dead ass tired, like not one day off of 30
days. Did you wake
in a
up
row.
With your dick hard too?
Yes.
What? Guys wake up with their dick hard.
That's what I'm saying.
I can understand being too tired. I can understand.
Oh, and let me tell you. Okay, I have a perfect example of artists always having time, even if they're tired. Because I was dating an artist, and he was like, "Babe, come meet me in the studio." He actually wanted me to work with him on something, right? Whatever, I'm doing it.
Oh shit!
We get back from the studio. We get back from the studio 6 a.m. I get in the shower. By the time I come out the bathroom, he's dead sleeping. He's knocked out. So there's an example of the guy being too tired. But guess what happened in the morning?
As soon as he woke up.
Dick was like,
guess what happened in the morning before I even woke up? I had
Dick was like this.
Exactly.
Nah.
He was knocking
through the ceiling.
There is opportunity.
Let me ask you a question. Is it so what it sounds like he made a bad decision? Is he still riddable right now to this day? Is he still sitting crazy all this shit?
What is he a good artist?
Is he still
successful?
Yes, he is still a successful. You know, you can be rich. And
yes,
you
with
made
the
money.
Music. Yes, absolutely.
He a bad motherfucker.
Why? But what? What happened? What's wrong?
I'm saying like when you tired, like new.
Nah,
bro,
he was tired. He was tired
like,
as fuck.
The shit you do as artists, like, is really like.
I'm telling you,
we were
up till 6 a.m. By the time I got out the shower, he was snoring.
Tip jar, what percentage of male artists?
He must borrow his manager dick.
What percentage of male artists?
Nah,
what percentage of men that are rappers you think cheat? If you had to guess,
all of them.
Damn,
nah,
100%?
All of them.
Nah,
all of them.
All of them.
She big player hate now. She's big player hating on the
rappers.
Big
player hating.
Big, I'm talking about.
Big rapper.
It's time. You can get it in the studio. It's time. There's opportunities for it to happen.
Right.
Like, and then, like she said, like every they have somebody in every state that they've
and
been
if they
dealing
got
with.
Somebody,
they there's
with
somebody in every city that's willing.
And it's more than
and make
one
it
somebody. It'd be like 3 New York.
Right.
Wait,
exactly. 4 or 5 Houston.
Black Youngster's supposed to be doing a song for
look,
us.
Look, he laughing because I'm right. His man even laughing.
He's supposed to do a song for us. Y'all need to back up a little bit.
I'm doing that song for y'all.
Lip service.
I'm doing a look. I'm going to make a call.
Nah, that's already. He already said he was going to do that.
I'm
going to
do that. I'm going to do that for sure.
Okay, I got that already on film.
What does man mean when he says, "I think I might be in love with you"?
I think.
Aww.
I think. Nobody says that. Nah. They be like, "I love your freaky ass."
Now wait, I love playing. Your fine ass.
I've had somebody that he's
say to me, "I think I'm falling in love with you."
Okay.
This. Okay.
I've had that happen to me. I don't know what it meant. But I've had him say that, and eventually he was like, "Bitch, I love your ass."
Yeah.
And then you killed him.
You know when a nigga love you. When a nigga love you, nigga put you. I'm talking about nigga gonna put you for anybody.
Okay, before anybody.
Anybody.
Before what about his kids?
Trip? Anybody.
Kids?
No.
Yeah, that's a.
You can't never.
That
man
said the Bible said
kids.
It in the Bible, but we know you don't live by the Bible, so that don't even matter. Yeah,
I live by the Bible.
Yeah, like when you love. I mean, when you love, I can relate to that. Like, I think I'm. No, I can't. Because when you love somebody, you don't even play with the word love.
Right.
First of all, and you got all these gay niggas. They meet niggas every day and tell them they love me, my partner, bro. Or girl, I love you. I can't play with that love word. That's one word I don't play with.
Mm-hmm.
Don't never play with the word ever.
Preach.
Ever again.
Don't I don't
ever.
Play with the
you
love
think you,
word.
You think you could love somebody that you never even like slept with or anything?
Yeah, because I love Lady Gaga.
I love her too.
Love Lady Gaga. Where the fuck did that come from?
I love her.
Yes, Little Monsters.
I'm not trying to have sex with her.
I know,
I'm not trying to sleep with her or nothing.
But you love her. You
but love I love her.
She's an incredible artist. I love her too.
Yeah. What? Damn right.
Why you say it like that?
Cause it's like they feel like I don't know. See, I don't want to get your dudes in trouble. Like,
no, we want to know.
I'm just saying, like, man, I don't play. Like, I'm putting Mac down.
Love at first sight is a real thing.
Yeah, like,
oh,
love
at first
real.
Fuck no, I'm, is a real
no,
thing.
No, I'm not.
Sure.
That wasn't a question.
Love at first fuck is real.
That wasn't a question. I was saying it. Love at first sight is a real thing.
It's real.
Love at first fuck is a real thing, too.
Trust me, I know about it.
Yeah. I don't believe in
love at first fuck is a good thing, too.
You know when you love somebody.
For real?
Yeah, you know you love somebody.
First, when they put your shoes in the
side. Because he keep kicking them out his leg.
Now I'm trying to kick him out the way. Like, how I know when I love somebody, that mean I'm willing to do anything in the world for you and with you, and I'm willing to go against anybody, I don't care who it is, for you. You know what I'm saying? Like, literally. Like, because the thing is, like, man, people be playing. They do the fake love and shit. Like, mm-hmm. My love, like, if I love you, I'm going to make sure you straight for the rest of your life, no matter if I'm with you or I ain't with you. As long as you're doing, being respectful. You know what I'm saying?
Is this the same guy that said he's going to take back cars and houses?
No, real no, I'm saying, but love, like, when you love like, somebody, you don't want to see nobody.
He's saying that now because he might be in love.
He is in love.
When it's over.
But you don't want to see nobody you love go down through it. Like, who want to see somebody you love just fall? Like,
no, never.
That's sucker shit.
But can you fall out of love, though? Yes.
No.
I think you can fall out of
love.
You
can fall out of love. Only way you can fall out of love if like, you really...
It wasn't real.
Like, nowadays, people be making the wrong excuses to fall out of love.
What if the person you love break your heart?
I hope you gotta die.
I want to know what the excuses are. You said some people make the wrong excuses to fall out of love. Like, what is?
Yeah, I believe in, like, just say, like, for example, you do your thing, you get money, you hustle. No matter if your nigga broke, got money, ain't got money, you know what I'm saying? Like, no matter what situation it is, you supposed to be stick beside his side. Now, I do agree, if he comes make bad decisions when it comes out of financial, mm-hmm. like, you got to go on and make a decision. It ain't about love at that point. It's like, bro, I love the fuck out you, but I know what I'm trying to be in life. And I know what I'm trying to get to. Mm-hmm. So maybe I love you, but I need for myself, I need to let this go because this ain't going how I want it to go.
You pulling me
how
down.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, because nobody want to be nobody that ain't going to be successful never in your life. Right. My nigga, you mean to tell me you never going to be successful? Like, never.
Ambition is very important.
Yeah, like, right. So, but like, love is strong. That shit's serious. And it's a word to not play with. And nowadays, people tend
love
to play
is a
with
word
it a
not
lot.
To play
like, yeah.
I feel like you could fall out of being in love, still love somebody, but not feel so passionately like you want to be with them.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
You love them, but you're not in love with them.
I feel like everybody. That I have fallen in love with, I still love them, but I don't feel in love with them.
You don't be like, I want to suck your dick when I see you.
Right, like someone I could think of that I loved so much, made me cry or whatever. You know, because love, when love is all about how much you're willing to suffer for another person. That's all it is. You know when you're in love, when something that other person could do could really hurt you.
Yeah. Make sure I go check my new video, my new booty video out. Booty. You know what I'm saying? I got Angelina that thing twerking.
No. Can you push the money?